Well, guess what, folks? It is minus 40 outside. Minus 40. If you think on your life I'm standing outside and shooting a video for you guys at minus 40, you are out of your minds. So instead today, I'm sitting in my house. I'm in my chair. Usually I got my feet kicked back. I got my little boy here. Hey, look at my little man. This is Charlie. Charlie trucked with me for many, many years. He's unfortunately now he's a little too old to go and on the road. So he's a good lap dog and he just stays home and keeps mama company. But one thing Charlie and I are gonna talk to you today about is the Detroit engines. We pushed this engine because I bought one, or I'm gonna say Ronan likes them. ET has them in their entire fleet. All of our Freightliners have them. We've got the DD15 engine. But there are some common issues with these engines. So, you know, just because we're big advocates of the engine and we like the engine doesn't mean that, you know what, it's the greatest thing in the world. So we're just going to give you a list of some of the most common issues. And these are things that we've been able to call around different shops and go on the internet and find, and just, you know, asking guys, what are the common things? When these trucks are coming in with check engine lights, what are you finding the most of? And this is what we came up with. It's not a big list. Believe it or not, it's not like what, you know, in the D13 Volvo engines where the list would be like from top of my head to the tip of my toes. And this is basically between the 2020 and the 2022 models. This is the biggest one. All of them said this, low oil pressure problems. They start their truck, the truck runs, they might be able to get it up to temperature, your oil pressure builds up. It doesn't go as high as it's supposed to, but then when you're driving, you're dropping oil pressure. Now, luckily for me, I haven't had the issue, knock on wood. But what's causing it? Well, the main problem that they're finding is the O-rings in the oil suction manifold harden. To a mechanic, that means a lot. To me, that means, what do? I have to call somebody. It's a real simple fix. It's not a major, you know, overhaul. You drop the oil pan. Drop the oil pan and replace the gaskets. It's as simple as that. But that's the number one thing for oil pressure. That's the one thing that they've been finding. There's other little things, but they're all scattered, but that's not a major problem. But the O-rings seem to be the main issue for low oil pressure on these trucks. What's the next issue, Charlie? He doesn't have a clue. The next issue, if you've got a DD15, they seem to be having is oil leaks. Now, back in the day, Detroits were known, and they were famously known for slobbering, leaking oil. I had a 60 series Detroit, and if I parked my truck and there wasn't a couple of spots of oil under the truck and it was clean, I was worried. The 60 series Detroit engines were famous for leaking oil. And like I said, back in the day, they called it slobbering. The DD15s are not so much. They seem to have, you know, obviously come along with the times, but they do have some oil leak issues. Generally, not your head gasket. You're usually pretty good on the head gasket, but you're looking for any kind of leaking around your fuel pump, air compressor, your oil coolant system. That whole system, end to end, check that, okay? You could have leaks. Now, I'm not saying if you find a leak on any of these little things that you need to be ripping parts out and replacing them. You don't, but they are known to leak, and it's specific usually to the Detroits. The camshaft housing, now this is a big one, okay, because they do have to fix this. The only way to fix that is you are replacing gaskets. Unfortunately, you are. Pretty much with just about any oil leak on these trucks, it's a gasket or a seal or something along that nature that is gonna be causing the leak, right? You get a leak from somewhere when you've got two hard surfaces that have to come together. There's usually a gasket or a seal in between it, right? Makes sense. Somehow or another, through time, they dry out, use, age, whatever. Something in that gasket or seal cracks, breaks, lets go. Liquid will always find a hole, and it will always find its way through if there's a hole. It doesn't matter if it's oil, it doesn't matter if it's water, it doesn't matter if it's coolant, it will always get through. So you're gonna be replacing the gasket on that, unfortunately. There's a lot of guys out there that are using cheap oil or crap oil, okay? They always recommend that you use the manufacturer's recommended oil, okay? So basically, go into your manual, go into your dealership. The dealership will tell you what engine oil came in that engine, stick to it. Some guys like to mix up the weights, change the weights around. Cold weather, hot weather, that's fine. But do not use cheap crap oil that you can, if you can find oil for $1.25 a gallon, don't buy it. It belongs in your lawnmower. Don't touch it. So stick, that's the biggest thing they said, is people get have a tendency to use the cheaper oil. They don't get the lubrication that they want. Their gaskets are drying out, their seals are drying out, and they've got leaks and they got problems. Now, I'm sure you guys are gonna pipe in. There's gonna probably be 3, 4, 5 more. You'll pipe in and let me know whatever else you're leaking on. Again, so far I've been lucky on mine. I don't have a lot of these issues. I really don't. So we're good on that. So there you go on your engine oil. Hey guys, just a quick side note here. It doesn't matter if you're a Canadian driver or a US driver. If you're looking for financing, hit the link at the bottom of this page. It's gonna take you to 5 different finance companies that are gonna fight for your business. Remember, these guys all make commission on top of the rate that they get you. You want the lowest rate, so why not have them fight for you? So hit that link, it'll take you 20 seconds, fill out the form and it will go out and you will get the best rate and you will get the best people working for you. The last biggest one, and this can be expensive, unfortunately, and it seems to be something that a lot of manufacturers over the years obviously have had to deal with because of the new technology. Detroit is suffering with it. Now, I'm not gonna say so much on the 2022s and the 21s, but the 17, 18, 19, and 20s did have issues with this, and this is what they're still dealing with because a lot of these trucks are still on the road. It's the EGR, the valve and the cooler. It's a combined set, they work together, they work in tandem. I know that an EGR valve is upwards of $1,000 plus a couple hours of labor, it depends, but it's expensive. The cooler, I have not had to replace a cooler on mine. But I do know that on the D13, the Volvo, the cooler on that thing ran me $2,800 and 5.5 hours of labor. That's a lot of money, folks. So the EGR cooler, and EGR, what does this stand for? It stands for exhaust gas recirculation. Good thing I'm not drinking trying to say that, eh? Man, that's a mother. Okay, I'm not gonna try to say what EGR stands for again. That's already a mouthful. But what does the valve do? The valve basically blows about 10% of the exhaust back into your manifold. What does the cooler do? The cooler cools the air going in. These are common issues. If that valve for any reason sticks open, now I'm not gonna go into this because we've actually got another episode explaining what the EGR cooler does and what the EGR valve does and common issues of what the problems are with these items. But we're just gonna touch briefly on the valve. The biggest problem with the valves is they get stuck open. It's low idling on these things. Carbon builds up because the engine's not at high temperature. It's not at optimum temperature. Carbon builds up on it because it's not burnt off. And what happens, it builds up, and the valve's stuck open. That's, you've got a problem. You'll have a check engine light, probably have a knock sensor screaming. The cooler is just a simple, it's not a simple fix. A lot of guys have tried cleaning them. They don't recommend it, just replace it. But those just get clogged. On the D13 Volvo, I had to, in 7 years, I did 2 of them. I did 2 valves and 2 coolers. And they both times that cooler was clogged solid. I mean, we took it out, flashlight went down. It's just not worth cleaning. If you do it and it's working for you, great. Me, just replace it. So the EGR valve and the EGR cooler are still items on the list that the Detroit and the dealerships are still working on. They're still coming in with check engine lights and they're still getting problems with them. So there you go. Those are probably the 3.5 biggest items that Detroit is dealing with right now. If there's anything else you've got, anything you're dealing with, you don't have an answer to, don't ask me, man. I'm not a mechanic, but throw your comment down there because you know what, we got enough guys now, we've got enough subscribers now, we've got enough people now reading through these comments. I guarantee you throw your problem down there, somebody probably has an answer and it won't cost you $800 to get some guy to plug your truck in. So there you go.